In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Surface Area of Prisms and Cylinders. The directions for this section are to copy the measurements given onto the net of each solid. So looking at number one, we can see our three-dimensional figure is a cylinder. And the net of that three-dimensional figure is below. So we're to copy the measurements that are given within the solid, or within our three-dimensional figure, onto the net. So we can see that the height is 7. So if we were to label 7 below on the net, that would be the height of our figure. Within the base, it tells us that the radius is 4. So on one of the bases, you can choose essentially which base. I'll do the one on the bottom since that's where it's labeled in this. We're going to draw our radius and mark that as 4. Now let's move on to number 2. In number 2, you can see that we have a hexagonal prism. And the height of this hexagonal prism here is one base. So therefore, the height is this 9. So we'll label the 9, which is the height, so the distance between the bases. And you can see that the side length of the hexagon is 8. So each of these sides is 8. But we only need to label 1, since it's a regular hexagon. So we label 8, and then our apothem is 6.9. And remember, the apothem is from the center of the hexagon, or the center of the polygon, perpendicular to the edge. So marking the center, drawing a line perpendicular to the edge, that's our apothem, which is 6.9. And that is our labeled net for number 2. And number 3, this is a pentagonal prism. So we have 5 sides, where each side length on the base is 13. So let's start by marking the measurement 13. Well, since the edges of that pentagon are congruent, we can label any one of them as 13. Now the height of this pentagonal prism is 5, and that's essentially the distance that connects the bases together. So this is 5, this is 5, this is 5. All throughout those measurements are 5, and we only need to label one of them. And then lastly, the measurement given is their apothem, which again goes from the center of the polygon perpendicular to one of the edges. And that measurement is 8.9. On to number 4, again we have a pentagonal prism. Let's start with the height this time. The height is 8, which we know is the distance if we were to connect the bases together. That is 8. And the height is congruent throughout, so labeling any of those would be appropriate. Next, we can see that the side length of a base is 13. So next, we'll mark 13. And then lastly, our apothem, which is perpendicular to an edge or to one of the sides of the pentagon, and it goes to the center, and that's 8.9. In number 5, we have a rectangular prism. Now this one is a bit more tricky since the bases are also rectangles. So let's start with the smaller rectangle. This is 5 by 15. So we know that this smaller side length is 5, whereas this is 15. And if that's 5 by 15 there, then this longer length is 16, or essentially the height. So from base to base, that would be 16. Therefore, this is also 5. Making this 15, and again this is 5, so this length is 15, and this length is also 15. Think about folding this back up together to form that box. If we were to fold over on this line and fold these sides up, this 15 would touch this length of 15, and this 15 would touch this length of 15. And same with below. So if you ever get confused, think about folding that net back up into the figure. Now lastly, for this set of directions, number 6. Number 6, we have a cylinder. So right away we can see that the height is 10. So this length is 10. And we're given the radius of one of the bases, so we'll be able to draw the radius of 2 within a circle. And you can draw that radius in either of the circles since they are the same. Now, in the next portion of this worksheet, we're going to be finding the lateral area, and then we're going to be finding the surface area of each of the figures, and we're to round our answer to the nearest thousandth if necessary. Now, we're going to be picking up with number 7 in the next video. However, I want to go through the steps quickly while we're still given the diagrams. So if we were to find the lateral area, let's say, of number 6, the lateral area is the area excluding the bases. So that would be this area here. And the surface area is the area of the entire net. So that would include the bases. So just remember how a net is formed and how to label a net, and that'll be useful in the next video. Continue on to that. Like, subscribe, and share.